Key. So to make sure that your automotive, residential, and commercial properties are protected, trust JAM AllSafe and Secure Locksmiths. They're the key to sensible security. They're an authorized multi-lock dealer with high security solutions for home or business that is true intruder resistant. For more information, call 727-474-6906 or visit the shop at 13030 Starkey Road in Largo. JAM AllSafe and Secure Locksmiths, the key to sensible security.
It's time for the Brian Cash Claus Show. Stay tuned to learn about the great deals you can find in the BCC coupon book. Now, here's the host with the most, Brian Cash Claus, and his very special guest.
Noon Tampa Bay.
Hello, Tampa Bay.
Hi. So we have Angel in the house today. How are you doing today on this beautiful day?
I'm doing just fabulous. How about you?
Awesome.
You look great, by the way.
Oh, well, thank you so much.
Well, you always look great.
Oh, thanks. I've actually... enjoying this beautiful weather the last couple of days. It's been so nice.
Absolutely. It's been awesome. I wish I could enjoy it more. But well, I get out at 5 and I'm stuck in traffic for almost an hour and a half. So I'm jealous for those folks
that
are close to work.
You're stuck in your office, aren't you?
Yeah, I'm stuck in my office.
See, I'm in and out of the car all day, so I get to be outside all day.
I'm jealous.
But it's been very beautiful out. So what do you have going on? Tell us anything special you have.
Well, last Wednesday, I wasn't able to join the radio show because I was at an NAREP and a PFC Black Chamber of Commerce meeting. It was sponsored by Truist, and it was a networking event in conjunction with the, sponsored by Truist. And I was able to meet with a lot of individuals in the community. They were Black leaders in the community. They have their own businesses, and it was a great way for them to network with lenders and other like-minded individuals to help, you know, just finding out more resources for them to grow their business. So it was an awesome experience, and I met a lot of inspiring people.
Oh, that's very awesome. So where was the event at?
The event was located in the city of Tampa. It was it was located at 615 Channelside Drive. It's a rooftop garden there.
Oh.
It's right next to the Tampa Bay, the City of Tampa Aquarium.
Oh, beautiful.
They rehab the whole area. So the very top of it, I didn't even know. It's for office space. And a shared office space.
How beautiful.
I didn't even know that.
Neither.
And it oversees the water and oversees all the activity in the bottom half. It was really nice.
Oh, what a great place for an office.
Absolutely. That sounds pretty cool.
So how was the turnout?
They had at least over 100 people or more there.
Wow, that's awesome.
Yeah. So it was nice. You know, they provided food and little awards here and there, but it was great. It was a good experience. You know, I'm excited to see that more of the, like Truist Bank specifically is reaching out to the Black community to try to connect with them and help inspire them to getting loan products to help their business grow. So I think that's pretty awesome.
Right. So were you able to share any of your resources with anyone there?
Well, actually, the reason we were invited to go, because I do have, I play two roles, right? So I work for Tampa Bay Neighborhood Housing Services. We provide housing opportunities as far as home buyer education classes for first-time home buyers. And because there were association realtors there, we made a lot of contacts in respect of them knowing what we do. The second component, as far as the resources is concerned for the community, I usually have those meetings offline, if you will, right? So if I see there's a need for it or helps them, then I let them know about those resources.
Nice.
But during that time, I was mostly focused on, getting in contact with the real estate agents, looking at them, talking to business owners and seeing how we can kind of collaborate.
That's awesome. So while we're on the subject,
yes,
tell us a little bit about the program that you are part of, and if anyone would be in need of those resources, how would they get in touch with you or the program itself?
Like, for example, if you're looking to try to purchase a home and you want to purchase a home in Largo, Florida, or you want to purchase a house in the city of Clearwater and within the city boundaries, I am their point of contact. They refer all the first-time home buyers to me.
Oh, nice.
So I take care of all their down payment assistance. So it's basically, it's all based on your income. So I pretty much administer the paperwork for that, you know, get you pre-qualified for it. And then I also go to the closings for you. And I basically is what I do from the beginning to the end, get your pre-approved for that down payment.
Right. So from my understanding of speaking with you about this program, there are some resources out there that I bet there are people they're not aware of what is available to them as a first-time home buyer here.
True.
So what types of assistance can they actually get?
Like, for example, as like you're right, a lot of people don't know about it. And the way they find out about it is word of mouth or by other lenders that I've worked with in the past. A family can earn up to $87,000. So you're not limited. Just because you're making over $90,000 a year, which is pretty good money, by the way, there's still some assistance for the folks. If you want to buy in the city of Largo, you can get up to $15,000 for your first home. Mm-hmm. So don't let income be a deterrent if you're making a little more than the norm. But so if you're below 80%, for example, or 50, or if you're making, like, let's say $40,000 a year, $30,000 a year, it's considered low, 80%. You can get up to $75,000 for your first home.
That's amazing.
Isn't it? It's amazing.
Now, that is money that they don't have to pay back, correct?
Exactly. Well, the city of Clearwater has a grant for $15,000 that you don't have to pay back.
Right.
But they have $45,000 that after 5 years, you pay $96.75 only for 250 months, and you only pay half of the $45,000. The other $22,000 is forgiven.
Right.
So that's great information. Now, in the city of Largo, they're a little different. They, you know, the payments are 5 year deferment. You pay $168 a month for the 25 years, and you pay the full amount back. But what they're trying to do, I had a discussion with the city of Largo, they want to be competitive with other municipalities. So I think they're having some conversations and seeing how can they be on the same page, which is a good thing, right? Because I'd rather save money than spend all that money, right?
Right. So that's a new city you're working with, right?
Yes, I was specifically working with the city of Clearwater. Now I've expanded to the city of Largo. We're actually working with the city of Tampa as well.
Wow.
So we have a rep doing down payment assistance for them as well. So if you want to buy a house in Tampa, city of Clearwater, Largo, we have you, because we take care of all those things. If you want to buy a house in St. Pete, for example, St. Pete, they have their own programs, but they do honor our home buyer education class certificate. So they will take that because you have to take 8-hour home buyer education class. It's the first step.
Right.
And they honor our certificates.
That is amazing.
And by the way, you get $96,000 in St. Pete.
Wow.
Isn't that crazy?
That's great.
Yeah.
Right. So if anybody has any interest, or if you're thinking about buying a home, or let's just say you don't think you can buy a home because you're getting ready to rent another home or something, just maybe find out some information and see if you qualify. I mean, I feel like it's much better to pay a mortgage payment than it is to pay rent, because in rent, you're not getting absolutely anything for it. At the end of the day, it doesn't count at all.
You're absolutely right. And there was a new law. And by the way, if you want to reach out to us, it's Tampa Bay Neighborhood Housing Services. The number is 727-442-4155. I'm at extension number 112, Angel Santiago. Just ask for me and I'll point you in the right direction. If I don't have the answer, I'll point you. I'm not going to pretend like I know it. I'll do the research and help you if you're looking to try to purchase a home. I know there's a new law that just came out for realtors that the 6% is no longer. So commissions they're not going to be able to get commissions like they used to.
Oh, wow.
So I'm very curious how that's going to affect the market.
Yeah.
So people get into real estate because they want to make those commissions.
Right, of course.
So I think in the future, a lot of the folks that want to buy a home may struggle with getting a realtor to represent them. So there might be some things changing in the future and how that's going to look like.
Wow.
That's amazing.
That is really.
Yeah.
Wow.
I know. It just came out. I mean, I have lenders reaching out to me saying, hey, by the way, can down payment assistance cover those commission costs? And unfortunately, it can't. It only covers down payment assistance and closing costs, not commission.
Okay.
So the buyer has to now pay for those commissions or find some other way of trying to figure out how they can find how.
Wow. Are they doing that across the country?
The whole state.
Or just Florida?
State.
Okay.
there was a major lawsuit. Apparently, what happened was that a lot of realtors and they kept the market pretty high, you know, as far as the cost of living. Of course, first of all, the cost of living is pretty high, but the value of the houses has been maintaining at a higher level. But what's happening is with the 6% is driving the cost even higher.
Right.
So it's making them unaffordable, right?
Right.
So apparently they were manipulating the market to have the prices of the houses stay higher so they can make a bigger commission bonus. Right. So,
well, I've been reading a bit myself about the market here in Florida, and we are one of the higher on the higher end across the country.
Yes.
Because basically, you know, it all started with COVID and then everything got more expensive. But a lot of other states, the price has come down and here it hasn't. So,
well, now because of that law passing, you're going to find more prices of homes actually become lower now.
Right, right.
Because, you know, less people, you know, the realtors,
of course,
they're going to start dropping like flies, unfortunately.
Yeah.
So so that's going to really, I'm just kind of curious how it will affect the market. It's, you know, it's I guess it's a good thing, I guess. But again, it's, you know, it's going to be the buyer now paying for that commission. So it's going to be very interesting.
Yeah.
Anyways.
Is that really, that just recently happened?
Yeah, it just recently happened. Yeah.
When?
Happened like last week.
Really? So now the buyer pays the salesman's commission?
Be able to have to pay the 3%. So usually when you're a realtor, right, you charge 6% commission, right? So 3% goes to the
house. Is that good for a salesman or bad for a salesman?
Bad for a salesman, because think about it. If you're in the real estate, you're in the market, it makes
stuff. You might sell your own home, though.
Well, I mean, it's different. But if as a realtor, you make your money off these commissions. So now that that's been eliminated. That's going to be very difficult for those folks that want to be in that career or that trade to be making as money as they used to. So that's going to be very. Yeah. I'm very curious how
this
the market
is nationwide or just
nationwide.
And who made that decision?
It's got to be through the federal level.
Did you know about that?
Yeah. Well, I'm not sure how much of it is decided yet.
Vince,
right?
Come on over here. We'll switch.
I think it was a lawsuit that started it or something.
Yes, a lawsuit started it because what happened is they were, you know, I don't know if you remember like the real estate bubble, how they were controlling the market.
Yeah.
So what happened was that these realtors associations were keeping, like they were pushing for higher value of houses, the prices of houses really high. So obviously somehow they was manipulated at the price of houses. They wanted to maintain them higher. Why? Because they get a bigger commission. So when they found out that they were able to manipulate the market for driving higher prices for homes, which commission does drive the values higher, well, they wind up, the National Realtor Association got fined millions of dollars.
Really?
So
it was like a landmark settlement,
yes,
like $100 million or something?
Millions.
A huge amount.
So they decided, well, to avoid all this from happening, then the 6% commission is no longer on the table.
Wow. Hey, Joey, did you hear about that?
I'm listening to the whole thing. Yes, sir.
You knew about it, huh?
I do.
Wow, how come I didn't?
All my clients talk about it. I got a bunch of realtors as clients, and I hear them, you know, their realtor talk, and it's
now, are they for this bill or are they against it?
They're against it.
I think they're against it, yeah.
Really?
It's their association, though, that voted for it, though,
something
right?
Something like that. I'm not really, you know, I don't know the fundamentals of it. I just listen to the conversations, you know what I mean?
It's so what's going to happen to the market because of that?
The National Association of Realtors settlement could have impacted real estate. So it's actually the national, okay? National Association of Realtors, they're the ones that settled. What's going to happen? We're going to find out. What I'm thinking, my prediction is that there are going to be less people going into the real estate market as being sales reps because there's not too much commission in it for them, right? Which means that less and less people are going to be able to cater to folks that want to buy homes. Therefore, it's going to be challenging. So something has to happen to think out the box to help these folks that want to buy a home. So if you have less realtors and the people that are in the market that are helping, they're going to be overwhelmed, right? So now who do they go to? So they may work with an attorney because attorney can work as a real estate agent. So they might have to work with their current attorney to try to find a home. That's one thing. Or perhaps go right to the seller and say, can we work something out together? And then
that's interesting. Hey, Joey, tell us what you do there, Mr. Joey. Is he still there?
Can you repeat that?
Okay, so tell us, you're there at a new salon. It's called, tell us the name of the salon.
It's called Beauty on Broadway. We're not actually a new salon. We've been around for 7 years. So we relocated to our Clearwater location, and we're getting it up and running. It's just we're colorist here. We're a color salon.
Wow, that's wonderful. Explain people how where you're at because it's interesting. Aren't you? Isn't there a Walmart?
We're right next to the Walmart marketplace.
Right.
You know, family marketplace, and we do really good in here.
Right. So then there's a Chinese restaurant there. I'm trying to give people
great Chinese
landmark.
Restaurant. Yes, sir. Right. Three doors down, Chinese.
And then there's a Metro in there.
We got a Metro PCS. Yes,
because you
do.
Guys are stuck in the corner, so that's why I'm trying to give people landmarks.
I appreciate that. Yeah.
Isn't there a Rent-A-Center in there too?
We're actually right next to the Rent-A-Center. We're on the right left side of the Rent-A-Center.
Yeah. So think Rent-A-Center, think Metro, and then you know that name of the salon is what, Joey?
Our salon's Beauty on Broadway.
So now people, you have a landmark of where it is. If you use Walmart, and then you go, it's north of the Walmart.
Of course. Yes.
Right. So okay. So now we got the line, because I think it's important to let people know where you're located.
Well, of course, that's the biggest thing. You know, they try to find us, but once they do, our business is a lot of word of mouth. You know what I mean? We make one customer happy, and then they bring their friends in, and this and that, and then round and round we go.
There you go. And it's on Highland, like Tammy just said, on Highland.
North Highland.
North Highland.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So, you know, we're here. We're 1831 North Highland, and we're ready for business.
Bless you.
You have a question for Joey, any Vince?
Tell us, you know, you've been in business how long, you said?
7 years.
The salon's been in business 7 years. I've been in the hair business 20 years. I've been doing hair 20 years, fifth generation hairdresser. My mother was a hairdresser. She was a big color educator. So I grew up in the business. I went through the Tony and Guy Academy, so I'm Tony and Guy trained. You know, as far as hair, that's a big name in the hair industry, Tony and Guy, TG products. So, you know, I'm just specially trained for that way.
Yeah, that's good. You can't buy experience, right?
You cannot buy passion. Anybody can go to school for this, but not everybody's got the passion for it.
Do you, do men's beards?
We do beard. We're a full service salon. We do men, women, everything, permanent makeup, facials, everything. We do everything.
I got my next secret salon. Shopper, huh?
Yes.
Yes, absolutely. We got something here for everybody.
You know what we do is we have a secret shopper that goes out, right? And he goes out and he shops at our customers.
Okay.
And then he comes back. We're going to send a secret shopper.
We'll never know who he is. We'll just have to, because we try to wow everybody. So.
But I'm just saying he's going to be secret. That's why it's called secret shopper.
I have a personal question. How do you maintain? Listen, I'm growing my beard out because my girlfriend wants me to grow my beard out, right? So my beard is like so snarly right now, going all over the place. How do you relax your beard?
All right. Well, so nowadays they kind of really got geared into men's grooming, right? Like the big men's hair salons are really popular nowadays.
Yeah.
I've always been a fan of the American Crew products where they do the grooming, the beard grooming and all that.
Uh-huh.
You know, it's definitely the biggest thing is the products you use in your hair and your beard and stuff like that.
Okay.
The cheap stuff, you're going to get cheap results. The top of the line products, you're going to get, you know, excellent results. That's the truth.
Wow.
You know, it's the products you're using.
Is Audrey there? Is that her name, Audrey?
Her name is Andrea.
Andrea. Is she there?
Andrea. She had to take care. She's got two kids. She's a mother of two, and she had to get the kids home. But so I took over on this one. But her also, she's good with the men. The men love her. She's a colorist. And, you know, so it's just her and I kind of as a team right now. And everything's been going perfect.
So how's Jose?
Jose is the actual owner. He's a great owner. He's just the salon coordinator, owner, and handles the day to day, the books and everything. And we do the hair. He handles getting the clients in the chair, and our job is to keep them happy.
Does he have another salon too?
No, this is the only one right here.
Okay, because he's sounding like he knows what he's doing.
I really like working for this man right here. You know, I like him at the helm. You know, he had the big salon in Dunedin on Main Street. You know, that was a big, big, big hair salon. But things changed. They kind of wanted to downsize a little bit. And I call this my little color studio, you know?
Sure. That's very good. And then is there a sign up yet?
We got our sign. We got our sign coming. That's how new we are.
Yeah, that's it. It's okay. So good. So I was going to say look for a sign.
Yeah.
You know what they say a business with no sign is, right?
Right. Well, kind of word of mouth, you know, people have been coming right to us, you know, things have been going great. I'm a new hairdresser here in Clearwater, so I'm getting my name out there, and it's going really good. I'm happy.
Well, yeah. And you're right there on Highland Avenue, North Highland. You're near the Walmart. Next, right in the same shopping center as the Metro and the Chinese and the Rent-A-Center. You guys are right there in the corner.
Absolutely.
And you know, you want to get it. We're going to send a secret shopper, and you want to make it two secret shoppers?
Make it five secret shoppers.
Two? Said,
bring them all in, man. That's what it is. You got 20, send them 20.
Can you be a secret shopper, too?
Absolutely. You know, because I'm trying to do it. I'm doing a promotion here.
I'll send you.
I'm getting new customers that want to come in the salon, come in for a complimentary blow dry with me and see how I do. And I guarantee they're going to love our salon.
I love the passion, Joey.
Yeah.
Something you can't buy is enthusiasm.
As we're talking about this, you know what I mean?
Yeah, you're doing a great job. And hopefully your brother, and you want to say a hello to your brother in Sarasota.
Hey, brother out there in Sarasota, my other hairdresser friend, Stephanie, here in Clearwater.
Very good, because we got Joey on the air, and the reason who gave the permission for this was Jose.
Sure. Well, I didn't need the permission. I just gave him the respect to ask him for the permission.
Yeah, I know, but I'm just saying.
I like the way he worded that.
Yes, but I like to, you know.
I think if I was Jose, I'd be very proud of you, my man.
He is. No, he is. No, definitely. No. Hold on one second. Let me get Jose to say something over there. Huh?
Okay.
Jose. We got Jose, baby.
Jose.
Now, you can talk in your Spanish language there.
Well, yeah. Go ahead. Is this all set?
Nah, he's in the middle of something. Just say hello, Jose. Hey, what's up?
Hola, Jose. ¿Habla español?
Sí, habla español.
Felicidades con tu negocio. Tú tienes un señor que te está apoyando aquí en el radio, aquí en Tampa Bay, en Tampa Talk. Tú me estás escuchando sobre tus servicios. Estoy orgulloso de tener un señor como usted en la comunidad, apoyando a la comunidad sobre los trabajos. Y ayudando a las personas a conseguir trabajo y me alegro, ¿sabes eso, José?
Bueno, sí, ayuda a ti, ¿no? Y igual estoy buscando gente, algún estilista que esté buscando trabajo, estamos contratando, así que...
Brian, they're talking about us.
So translation.
I like my Yelp account.
Look at Jose just says he's looking for folks, if they want to work as a hairstylist, he's hiring.
Very good.
So if you're interested in being in that career, definitely. Jose, what's your phone number?
Well, I'll give you my business phone, not the personal one.
Okay.
727-330-0584.
Do you know what we could do, Jose, too? Say this to him in the Spanish thing you do.
You can speak English. You just talk to him in English.
Okay, anyhow. what we can do is we can, in the Coupon Near You magazine, put a Help Wanted part in there too, that you're looking for hairstylists.
Okay, sounds good.
Because we're in all the hair salons in Clearwater. We're actually in your salon too. We're in the Rent-A-Center. Yeah. We're also in the Metro.
Well, I'm going to make an appointment to come over and see Jose because, like I said, I want to get my beard trimmed, you know, kind of look kind of nice, you know. It's looking kind of snarly right now, Jose. I got to get that down.
Look, if you go on our Google, you're going to see that we are one of the best. I mean, we got 4.9 stars, 219 reviews. Not a lot of salons have that good of a review, you know. So
that's awesome.
We're sending a secret shopper there, so you're not going to know who it is, Jose.
Send a secret one. Send him.
And then he's going to report back. Sometimes he comes back with bad news, Jose.
I doubt it. But, hey, tell him to book with Joey. Joey's the best one that we got here.
Okay.
And if you're bilingual, you hear it. It's español y inglés. He'll take care of you guys.
El único que habla español aquí soy yo.
Oh, he's the only one speaks Spanish.
I'm the only one. I'm the Hispanic owner, but I'm not a stylist. You're not going to see me here, you know, doing hair. But yeah, besides that, you know, look, if algún Latino que sea estilista, bienvenido.
So he's saying if you're a Spanish-speaking, hairstylist, come. You're more than welcome to join the team.
That's yeah, definitely. You know, we need somebody that speaks Spanish working here.
There you go.
100%. So anyhow, thank you. Give us your address and the name of the hair salon again.
Yeah, the address.
Do it in Spanish and American.
Yeah, all right. So the address is American First, 1831 North Highland Avenue, Clearwater, Florida.
And that's it. That's Spanish and English.
That's
it. English is also Spanish. You know what I'm saying?
You pay everything.
That's the address, okay?
Right. La dirección.
That's the address.
Give the address. See if you can do it.
I'm telling you, what he just said is that's it. You can't just translate. That's the name of the address.
Yeah, that is true. I mean, how am I going to pay it in Spanish? You know, I mean, that is the address.
That's the address.
Really?
You see, learn something new, huh?
So there you go. Hey, gracias, amigos.
If you put the address in Spanish on the GPS, it ain't going to take you here.
Did you hear me? Put the address in Spanish, it's not going to take him there.
Gracias, Joseo. No, this gringo is saying...
Está perdido. Él no era.
Gringo going to be there secretly.
All right. Bring it on, man.
Bring it on.
I ain't scared. Bring it on.
All right. Thanks, Joey. Thank gracias, Andrea. Jose. And yep. Thank you, Jose.
Okay, Jose.
Gracias. I appreciate it. I really do.
Okay,
God bless you.
All
buddy.
Right, I look forward to seeing your secret shoppers, all right?
All right. And they're not right, always guys. Good,
take
buddy.
Care. Thank
not
you.
Always good.
I always do the best I can. All right, thanks a lot, guys.
All right, God bless. God bless. That was pretty neat. Do we have Leo on? Leo.
Hey, what's up, Brian? How are you?
We got a commercial for you, Leo. Do you want to start with the commercial, or do you want us to let us give it to you, and then you tell us what you think?
Let me hear it first and kind of go from there.
All right.
Leo, this is the best man. Like, you guys, really, he's a pioneer in the industry, and he's a man of integrity. And I'm real honored that you do business with us, Leo.
Thank you, Brian.
Here we go. Are you ready? This is for the 420 event, and we're doing a live radio show there also.
Yep.
We be jamming at Purple Haze, Pinellas County, Tonic Tobacco and Accessories for the 23rd annual 420 Appreciation Customer Parties that day. That we be jamming on Saturday 420 and Sunday 421. We be jamming from noon till 10, and we'll be a jamming. We live reggae music too, and we have everything you need, accessories and pipes and some tobacco too. We be a jamming at Purple Haze Tobacco and Accessories here in Pinellas County. Location at 1099 9 Seminole Boulevard, Largo, Florida. We be jamming.
Hey.
And that's with no music, Leo.
Wow.
Well, what we're going to do is we're going to put music in the background, right, for that?
I'm speechless.
No, you know what you're supposed to say? I'm jamming. I'm jamming at the Purple Haze.
We be jamming.
I could see maybe that could be a song.
We be a jamming at the Purple Haze.
That'd be a great jam.
At the 23-420 Customer Appreciation Party sale that day. We be a jamming at the Purple Haze. We be jamming at reggae music from noon till 10 on 420 and 421. We be jamming, and having a good time. So bring your... Bring your dancing ways with me and get ready to smoke some tobacco and jamming all day long at the Pinellas County Purple Haze. Hallelujah.
Okay. No music, Leo.
I know. That's actually, what does he do for a living?
He's actually a preacher.
Don't quit his job.
he's a man of God.
That's awesome.
And he's gonna have DJ Black Pearl.
Yes. Yeah. Anyhow, tell us what's going on, Leo.
Well, we have our 23rd annual 420 Customer Appreciation Party, which is gonna be held at 10999 Seminole Boulevard. That's in Largo, Florida. On the corner of 110th and Seminole, right next to Charlie and Millie's. We start at noon, and we end the festivities at 10 o'clock at night. We basically are having it 2 days this year. It's going to be Saturday 420 and Sunday 421. So it's a two-day event. We have live music by Eruption. We have DJ Black Pearl is going to be filling in between the sets. We have a live glass blower called Tim McKinney. And Tim McKinney is going to be blowing glass at the property there.
Yeah, I blew a pipe last year there for my son. I don't know if that's inappropriate, but I did.
But
no, that's cool.
And then he has a nickname, and he carved his nickname. Not only can you buy the pipe, but they can put the initial, or they can personalize the pipe with your name.
Wow, that's cool.
And then we watched him do it. He customizes it. It's a customized pipe, and they actually do the blow in the glass and all that. It was a really neat thing.
That's now cool. This year, if you guys like food trucks, we've got Focheesy is going to be there on both days, on the 20th and the 21st. Then we have this ain't your typical food truck is going to be there on the 20th.
Oh my God, that's my client.
Is it cool? Well, they're going to be there. They're going to be there on the 20th.
That's amazing. And I didn't know that.
Fat Jacks is going to be there on the 21st.
That's my client too. How'd that happen? Awesome. Fat Jacks food truck, and she really is. She's a 5-star chef. Did you know that?
I told her. I said Brian sent me.
Unbelievable. See, that's why you're the best.
It's nice working
together. Make sure you get your little perks there. Okay.
No, I, you know, sometimes, you know, can you do this? Right? I know this sounds crazy, but if you want to live in the spiritual world, right? Can you give and ask no reward? Can you love with no price tag? Right? Just think. Just give because it's the right thing to do.
Of course, yeah.
It says this is important to put others' well-being ahead of your own. Can you do that?
Well, you definitely try.
There you go. And it's a happier way of living. And that's what you just did for me, Leo. You just gave to my clients, man. And and you made me look good.
That's it.
I love you, Leo.
I told him, I said, Brian sent me.
Unbelievable. That's it. Now that's they wanted their money up front then. I just found out something. I know maybe I shouldn't say it. He says I shouldn't just keep it quiet. Yeah, I tell you what. Not that I ain't going
to
say it.
Okay, good. If it's not good to say it, yeah, no, I'll say it.
Now you got to say it. Now you got to say it.
I love you, Leo. Okay?
No, I got a new thing. I got a filter. It just got installed today.
That'll last a minute.
It's a filter because I really want to say something that I just found out.
Leave it alone. Leave it alone.
I'll leave it alone.
Okay, good.
But it is amazing, though, what the computer can do, though.
Yeah.
No, be honest with you.
Anyhow. I'll tell you what, here's the truth. What? Brian, the truth is that you help a lot of people through these books. You are a reputable man. I myself just put it on that thing that you're talking about. And, you know, I think that the fact that we all come, show up, use the book, and I think it's a wonderful thing. And I do see you putting yourself out there.
So, Leo, thank you. But, Leo, talk about the event. Like, what are the things you got going on there? And because you have you're going to have the bouncy thing for the kids again this year?
We do have a kids corral at the location. Right. We also have, like I said, we have the food trucks, the live glass blowing. Now, we're going to have four vendors this year, and the four vendors are going to be giving away free merchandise. So we're going to do free dubs all day long, free smoke all day long.
You're going to have the t-shirt lady there again?
I'm going to try to reach out to her to see where she's at. I couldn't get a hold of her this year.
You know what? She gave out some really cool, looking t-shirts, to be honest. Yeah. I mean, really cool stuff.
So what do people do? Just come, hang out, smoke, kind of like a social event a little bit?
It's a social event, yeah.
So what happens at 4:20?
At 4:20, everybody gets to join. Everybody lights up.
It is the most amazing thing to be part of. You know, when we did the radio show there, Leo, there was a car accident that literally we're on. Right. You want to hear this?
I thought the filter was working. There goes the filter.
And I almost got killed. And, you know, we kept the show going, right? And then the show was going and all that, and we're having a good time. And then all of a sudden, people couldn't believe it. What just happened? You heard the screeching and the bang? Then the next thing you hear is the ambulance.
You know what caused it? They were probably looking at the parade.
That's it. The radio show.
Must have been the t-shirt lady.
The t-shirt.
Do you know what 420 stands for?
It's almost like, no, what does 420 stand for?
It stands for Adam 12, the radio show, the TV show that had the police on. 420, 420 in progress. Kids smoking pot behind the school.
Is that right, Leo?
They were definitely, yeah, smoking behind the school, yeah.
420?
Oh, wow. I did not know that.
Yeah, I always, do you ever wonder where things come from?
Yeah.
Adam 12.
Adam 12. 420
in progress. There is kids drink smoking pot behind the school.
Well, I didn't know that. So that's pretty cool.
Bad boys.
What are you going to do?
710 is another party day for him, and that is the oils. 710 stands for the oils, the shatter and the medical style. It could be any kind of style.
Do you remember, Leo, how you got into the industry? Like what? What led you to the industry, Purple Haze?
Well, 30 years ago, it was very voodoo to have a smoke shop. It was taboo. You didn't want a smoke shop because you're frowned down upon. But everybody needed a certain medication, and they needed a specialty place to go to for their accessories, and that's what we ended up doing. It worked out really good. Obviously, in the beginning, I had some issues with some local politicians, and the local politicians kind of brought me a lot more.
Okay, they there? We have somebody to put them on. We have somebody that wants to ask you a question, Leo.
Shoot, go ahead.
Okay, who is it that's calling in?
It's Serenity Dog Service, Brian.
Oh, my God. How are you, buddy?
Good. We're on our way to see you, but since you have the rush hour time slot, guess what we're in?
A traffic jam.
Unbelievable.
But speaking of free, we just heard we're offering a free dog walk for the first time. We'd like to meet new clients and meet the dog naturally. And so we're offering that, and we do. Besides watching, we do boarding. If you have some sort of appointments, we do drop-ins. Basically, we try to meet the client's needs in any way possible.
Do you have a question for Leo? He does the Purple Haze. He does the smoke shop. Because I know you guys do the vapes.
Do you have train wrecks? Kratom.
We do carry Kratom, yes. I don't carry that brand. I carry Choice brand, which has been around for quite a bit, is the Kratoms that we carry. We carry powder, we carry capsules, and we carry extract.
Excellent. Well, we go for the capsules. We'll come by. Now, which Purple Haze are you?
Now, if you come, we're going to be at our party. We're going to be doing free samples for Kratom as well.
Excellent.
So we have one of my vendors who's going to be there. And he's going to be doing shots all day long. Kratom shots.
Okay, so when is the party?
The party is Saturday, April 20th, and Sunday, April 21st.
And do you know what I was thinking is a good idea? Because, you know, we just found out, Adam 12, right, 420. Why don't we do next week's show? Because, you know, we're having TV cameras in here next week, Leo.
Yeah.
And what I'm thinking of doing is let's give away $50 because we're a big show. Anybody knows next week we're going to do the show of where 420 came from, the origination of it.
That's awesome.
Make that as a I'm going to tell you ahead of time a trivia question for next week's show. And then what we're going to do is we're going to give away $50.
Okay, so now what we're going to do is give our phone number out so that people can call us, because that's the only way besides your book they're going to find us, which, gratefully, yeah, your book proves to be very, very, very good for us. We do get a number of calls on the walk because of it, so we appreciate all that you do and getting us on the radio. So we can be reached at 727
831-3518 or 617-839-6908. And again, we're in Brian's book, which you can pick up just about anywhere in Pinellas County. We are, again, centrally located right there on 19th. We even have clients in Tampa. I know your show goes over there. You know, more of that would be boarding stuff or whatever. But just give us a call and we'll see if we can meet and take care of the dog. You know, we love animals. The dog gets to go to the beach if that's something that you would like for your dog. We do it. Dog parks naturally. I mean, we take care of them. They really get very, very good personal care and the love that they deserve.
Leo, do people give kratom or something like that to their dogs?
Not really kratom, mostly CBD.
Yeah, CBD is good
CBD, like we carry CBD biscuits and carry CBD serum for them. Hey, you know what I'm going to say? This is going to be a really good opportunity for you guys. A vendor dropped off some CBD serum, both subtle right. and relaxing. So I got relaxing and then what they call uplift. So I have both uplift and what they call settling. If anybody comes into the store and mentions the store or mentions that they heard of us on the radio station, I will give them two $49 bottles for absolutely free.
Wow.
Wow.
Awesome.
Well, put some aside for us, Leo, because my wife and I will definitely come by and we'll buy some CBD and Kratom for ourselves. But that sounds excellent. The dog we happen to have right now with us that we're taking care of was traumatized. He spent 6 months in the streets of San Juan after the hurricane. And the woman that adopted him, you know, he can't be left alone. So he's constantly with us when we have him, and he's fine as long as he's around. So maybe some of that calming stuff might
help. But like I said, you guys don't have to spend any money. All you got to do is say that you heard us on the radio station, and we'll give you a free bottle of the Settle, which is relaxing. And then a free bottle of the Uplift, and it's a $49 value of each. So it's $100. $100 you're going to get for free.
Give them the address again, Leo.
The address is 10999 Seminole Boulevard.
We've been by your shop, Leo.
Yeah. Well, I also have one on 3809 Tyrone Boulevard, too. And then I have one in South St. Pete.
That is amazing.
Oh, you're all over. But where's your shop? Go to the Seminole Boulevard one to see you.
I'm usually not at the stores. I do a lot of labor work, like fixing stuff. But we have probably 100 cases of CBD serums that we have to get rid of before the 420 event because that's where they blow glass at.
Where it's a 2-day party, right? Saturday and Sunday.
Yeah.
And I just want to mention one of our other clients is going to be out there with his food truck on Sunday, Fat Jack's on Wheels.
That's it. Yep.
Fat Jack is going to be there, yes.
Yep. Who did you get for Saturday?
Saturday is going to be not your typical food truck.
So, right. So, we both of them. That's awesome.
Yeah. And we have two food trucks in our coupon book, and two for two, Leo's helping us.
And they both actually have great, great, great food.
I mean, really, I think the best, and I wish I could just say this from my heart, because I'm convinced that Fat Jack's has the best steak and cheese out of anybody I've ever had.
Yeah.
I agree with that, Brian.
He really is the best.
Yeah.
I'm not just saying that because
he's from Pennsylvania.
And I even said to him, because when he caters our radio show, right?
Mm-hmm.
I said, like, he's smart because sometimes, like, I had someone do $1.99 gyro and they robbed the people. They gave him $1.99 gyro instead of giving them a $9 gyro.
Yeah.
So, in other words, because the sample is the idea to get you to come back. So then what did we ended up doing?
Oh, we always get food from there.
We ended up doing a party, and we catered, guess through who we catered through.
Actually, also, that's why Mark went there, because he tried the cheesesteaks that we had here.
Right.
No, their food is super good.
You're going to be happy with them, Leo. Fat Jacks.
Both of them. The other one, she does pineapples with rice and chicken. Oh, my gosh, so good, so good.
Yeah, and she's actually a five-star chef. She used to work in the hotels and the motels at these fancy hotels. Mm-hmm. And then she's really the real deal. She's like a high-class chef.
Yeah, so you guys got to come out on 420, the weekend, the whole weekend, Saturday and Sunday. There's going to be amazing food, glass blowing, so many cool free giveaways and all type of stuff. And we're doing a live radio show.
And we're going to do the commercial one more time. You ready? Here we
okay.
go.
Okay, hold on. We be jamming. At the Purple Haze Tobacco and Accessory in Pinellas County today. We've been jamming on 420 and 421. I'll tell you how you better be coming here, because we be a jamming from noon till from 10 to 2, 10 to noon. Where is it at? Oh, 10 to noon on 420 and 421. We got your Delta 8 THC products, no medical card needed. So we be jamming with the tobacco that you really need. I tell you, come on down and see us on our Customers Appreciation Day. Our party will be going with live music from DJ. Then from the DJ. Black Rock today. What?
You're fired.
I'm fired.
That's it. We should have quit while we were at, huh, Leo?
Yeah, for sure. That's what I said. Keep his day job.
I didn't have anything in front of me.
That was it. Anyway, we tried, though, right, Leo? Our heart's in the right place.
No, you guys are awesome, dude. I appreciate it.
Yeah, so anyhow, thank you for being on the show, Leo. In closing, what would you like to say? Anybody? Silence is not good.
Jamming.
That's it, Leo. Leo, you should say, you know what you should say, Leo? We'll be jamming.
Brian, we're jamming here at Serenity Dog Service. 727-831-3518 or 617-839-6908. Serenity Dog Service. Just pick up Brian's book and we'll give you a deal.
All right, buddy. And we'd like to thank Frank's Pizza, right, for all the great food they give us. They bring us pizza, meatballs, everything. It's all good food here.
Was that what we had this time?
Yeah.
That was really good.
Frank's Pizza, right? That was great. And then he's a man that really – he had Fritzy Freeze. You know what his coupon was with me on the front cover? Free ice cream cone. No purchase necessary.
Oh, that's a great gift. That's great.
Right. And then there used to be a line of people outside his store.
Who's going
to
come in and not get other food, right?
Right. And who comes by themselves?
Nobody. Yeah.
Right. I try to explain that to people. Like when you pull over, you and your wife go, even if I gave you a free meal now, Vince, who are you bringing with you? Your fiance.
Oh, my fiance. Every time.
Every time.
Yeah, every time.
Right? So you're not going to go. Even if I said it's free, you're going to go eat by yourself?
Heck no.
Right, that's the whole point. So this guy was a genius. Everything he touched was Midas. So what would you like to talk about?
Well, it sounds like we got people going by Purple Haze now too. I was off the headset, so I missed it.
But tell us what's going on with you, like what you do.
Well, we're awmlocal.com, and what we do is we do the coupon book kind of thing, only we do it digitally. So what we do is we help people, businesses, get out there and get their ads on Facebook, you know, all the social medias. So go to awmlocal.com and, fill out that contact form, and we can get you some digital advertising. So
how do people go on Yelp? How does that work? What is Yelp? I want to know what it is.
That's an old platform.
Is that even still? Tell us, like, how do you get there if you wanted to
just
give me a review?
Just type in Yelp.
And then what they say, give a review? How does that work? So Yelp, give me the rundown of how to do it?
It just sign up. Just say
you
Yelp.
Just Google. I say Google Yelp.
Yep, it'll pop up.
And then what?
Then you have the option to download in their platform. Or you can just make a comment on a restaurant you perhaps just visit.
But how do they know what restaurant you want to comment on?
Well, your comments are going to be on that restaurant, whatever they're listing. It'd be a comment below that restaurant name.
So you got to put the name in then?
No, basically you pick the restaurant that you went to, right? And then below it, you have a room for comment.
Usually it's the, usually on the list, it's, you know, where you are is the closest that you've been to.
The search engine.
The search.
Yeah.
Can you do, I don't still understand
it. Okay, so for example, if you want to go to IHOP, for example, and IHOP is on the Yelp platform, right? So you click on it, Yelp. I'm on IHOP. It'll show up that restaurant and you put a comment of how your experience was.
But how about, like, say, someone like me, Brian Cash Claws? My name's not going to be on the platform.
No, I'm saying you can sign
up. How do I sign in to Brian Cash Claws on Yelp?
Well, you don't. Well, and anyone can go into Yelp and make a comment on a restaurant.
But how about a person, a business?
It could be a business as well. So if you want to name your business and you're saying, I'm Brian Cash Claws Show, I went to this restaurant, it was amazing, it'll show up to just the way, you know, you type it up. But they review everything now. They review all your comments as well and make sure it's an up and up, you know?
Well, why wouldn't it be?
No, I'm saying if you're a business reviewing another business, I don't see why that should be a problem. I don't work for Yelp. You have to look at the disclosures.
Yeah, you know, and if I had something negative to say, here's the thing. The more you're grateful for what you have, the more you get to be grateful for.
Yeah, that's for sure.
And then the more you complain about what you have, the more you get to complain about.
It seems like platforms like Google and Yelp, it seems like, unfortunately, a lot of times the only people who ever put anything on there is negative. And, you know, me and my fiance, we go out of our way if we have a good experience at a restaurant or someplace to put a positive review in there because, you know, that's important. Definitely right. Important because people use it as a, you know, as a way to judge whether they go someplace or not. And Google and Yelp now are so integrated and it's inescapable.
Right.
You know, if there's going to be, you know, Google, you know, feedback, there's going to be Yelp feedback too.
Well, you have to admit if like Sandshakers, he's another client of ours, right? He's got 5-star reviews over hundreds and hundreds of people who make comments on his restaurant. So if I'm going to look for a good restaurant for my first time ever, I'm going to take a look at the Google reviews. And if they have a 5-star rating and they have over 100 reviews, more than likely I might go to that restaurant.
And they're lovely people.
Yeah. Oh, absolutely. So it does help in that sense that if you're having a bad experience, I mean, I don't know about you, but if you've ever been to a restaurant and go in the restroom, it's like, that's so disgusting. And then you like, you know, the food is horrible. You're like, oh my God, I don't want people. I wouldn't bring my own mom there. So of course I'm like, hey, avoid this place. You know, if you see a cockroach rolling by your plate,
I wouldn't do that. That's my point.
I don't know, but people do. So it's,
I would,
but I would, you know why? Because I wouldn't want you eating somewhere where they have rats all over the place.
I wouldn't do it.
If it's as extreme as that,
yes,
but I'm not going to put some negative.
No, I know.
Right. I have something right now. We got to go. We got to close out.
Yeah, one more minute.
But I want to say something. I have people asking me to reference people for business.
We're wrapping up.
Wrap it up. And I never say nothing negative.
I got you. You're a nice guy, Brian.
I just can't do it.
Yeah.
God all right. Tampa Anyhow, Bay.
God bless everybody.
God bless everybody.
God bless everyone.
God bless everybody in the name of Jesus.
Yeah. Ayo, Tan Talk Radio. See you guys later. See you.
WTAN Clearwater
FM 106.1
WDCF Dade City
FM 102.3
Listen.
This is CBS News on the Hour, sponsored by Progressive Insurance.
I'm Monica Ricks. Still no decision from a federal appeals court on whether Texas can enforce its controversial immigration law. Reporter Chris Fox.
The Fifth Circuit Court will have to decide if Texas police should be allowed to arrest migrants believed to have entered illegally from Mexico and allow state judges to deport them. Texas Solicitor General Aaron Nielsen.
We are at the epicenter of this crisis. We are on the front line, and we are going to do something about it.
The U.S. DOJ and ACLU argued that immigration is the responsibility of the federal government alone.
More members of Mississippi's so-called goon squad are headed to prison. A third and fourth former deputy getting 17 and 40-year sentences today for torturing two black men last year. Attorney Malik Shabazz.
Let this be a strict warning to all rogue police officers in the United States of America that you will not get light sentences, that you will not be let off easy.
The last two defendants